Good day. My name is Martin Schweiger, and I will today walk you through Lesson 5 of our Marketing and Sales Bootcamp. This is an introductory course on how to increase revenues of a company. In today's Lesson 5, I will show you how to do A-B split testing with two landing pages. This is a lesson for nerds and for non-nerds. Let's recap. In Lesson 1, we have found out that the three only ways to increase revenue of a company are: sell at a higher price, sell more to the existing customers, or find more new customers. There is no other way to increase revenue of a company. We will today show you how to find more new customers with our method of two landing pages with A-B split testing. Let's recap again. We are using the law of big numbers, and for that we apply the sales funnel. The sales funnel has a funnel shape here. The top layer comes with the leads. The leads are converted into opportunities. Then we need to work our opportunities through the different sales stages, from prospecting, qualification, the needs analysis. Then we need to send a price quote or a proposal and negotiate and review and negotiate and review until we know whether we have won the deal or we have lost it. In average, we have to go through this 9 times, which means 9 contacts with our opportunities in order to find out whether there are a deal won or a deal lost. Now the big numbers come into the picture. Let's start with 100 leads. If we choose the leads carefully, we may be able to convert these leads into about 50 opportunities. From the 50 opportunities, we will generate about 5 deals won. Can you see this big difference here? We boil 100 leads down to only 5 deals won. These figures are quite accurate for application in practice. So now, what happens if we want to achieve 50 deals won? Of course, the law of big numbers says we need also 10 times more opportunities, which is 500. This is quite a large number, and imagine you will have to do 4,500 contacts with the opportunities in order to generate 50 deals. This is a serious work. In order to have the 500 opportunities, we will need 1,000 leads. And we don't want crappy leads, we want good ones, so that the chance is 50% to convert them into an opportunity. So, how do we do that? This is a typical Google search page. You enter a search term in the search line here. Here it is, office rental. As you can see here, the result page is split up into 3 parts. The first part are the results for the paid Google advertisements. You can see that because they come with a small AD symbol right here at the beginning of each result. It's highlighted here. Then we have the normal search result. They're also called organic search result here. They don't have this ad symbol here, and they are here because of search engine optimization. In the third part, you would see the local businesses that are registered under Google, and there are also 3 or 4 results displayed here. I have cut away the remainder of the page. Just to let you know, there are 3 different categories of search results: the paid AdWords results, the free organic results, and the Google businesses with a map. Now, let's recap again. We have our marketing channels. We need to decide where to put our marketing money. In the first place, we have unidirectional advertising. If you purchase an advertisement space in a newspaper, as you see here, these hamburgers, and then they would be displayed there. Problem is only there is no return on investment calculation possible, because we never know whether a customer would come to purchase from us because he has seen the advertisement or not. This is why we don't promote this. The same to public relations. If the editor likes your company, then he will mention you in one of those text sections on top of the advertisement. This can work in both ways, positively for you, but also against. And moreover, there is no return on investment, which means we don't know how much business we get out from a public relations campaign. This is why we don't recommend to invest into public relations. Then we have direct response marketing. Direct response marketing is all about getting engaged with our potential customers. Once there is a personal contact with a customer, we can far better fine-tune what we offer to him so that he would know what he buys. In addition to that, we know exactly how much money we invest into a customer relationship in order to make a closed deal. This is what we want. Apart from that, we have referral marketing. This is when your network is recommending your services or your products to their own network, and this would lead to closed deals. We also recommend that. But for the current lesson, we will focus on direct response marketing and how we can turn a Google AdWords campaign into a direct response marketing campaign. Let's look at our setup. We have here a company that wants to rent out office space in Singapore. Then we have a user. He lives in Singapore. His age is 30 to 55 and he wants to rent office space in Singapore. Seems to be a perfect match, right? We have the internet, and the internet comes with a Google search engine, the organic one, and it comes with a Google AdWords. So you pay for your advertisements here and user would see them with this little symbol. The direct approach would be that we program the Google AdWords or the Google search engine such that searches for office space rental in Singapore are forwarded to the company webpage. This is what we do not want because this is unidirectional advertising. It is very complicated to find out from where a new customer would come. Also, it is quite complicated for the potential customer to find information on the company webpage about what to buy and how much and more information. We will show you now how to turn this unidirectional internet advertising into a direct response marketing. We use a company landing page, and the company landing page comes with a call to action button. Upon pressing the call to action button, our user does a Google search for office rental or rent office or otherwise. We have purchased these AdWords with Google AdWords, so the search would be directed to the Google AdWords engine, and the Google AdWords engine directs the user, and we would not use the Google search engine. This means that we can save our expenditures for SEO, which is search engine optimization. We don't need that. Our Google AdWords provides a shortcut to the company landing page, and the user, upon clicking the call to action button, would send us his email address, and in exchange he gets something of value, namely a free content. And this is exactly what we need. We want his email address or other coordinates so we can enter into a direct contact with him. This is what makes a direct response marketing. Now let's look at the extended sales funnel that we have generated by doing so. We have about 1.75 billion Google searches per day, and by choosing the right targeting, we can boil these searches down to about 500,000 searches. This applies for our user in the age group of 35 to 50 and all those users who live in Singapore. By choosing the right keywords for the Google AdWords search, we can boil these 500k searches down to about 50 searches that are relevant for our product or service. By choosing the right contents on our landing page, means the ad copy, but not only the writing, also the graphics there, we can boil the 50 users down to about 10 for whom it is interesting what we have to offer. And of these 10 people, about 2 to 3 would click the call to action button and give us their contact details. This is by far not yet the end of the story. What we have done so far is we have only created additional leads for our normal sales funnel, which means per day you get 2 to 3 extra inquiries. This means also that you need to create opportunities from these leads, and you need to work 9 times on these opportunities in order to find out whether the deal is won or lost. There are several big advantages of applying this method to the Google AdWords searches. In the first place, we get a lot of feedback along the whole process. For instance, if the conversion rates of the leads that are created by our landing page are bad, then we can feedback that to the team that is responsible for the landing page and the processes that come with it. So if the conversion rate here is bad, then this team would check which one of the stages is responsible for the bad result. And in order to do so, they would look at the micro conversion rates in the extended sales funnel on top. For instance, they would check how many users that are already on the landing page would click on the call to action button and leave us their email address. If this number is very low, then something is wrong with the landing page and the call to action button. If the ad copy on the Google search page is bad, then the conversion rate from the Google result page to our landing page would be bad. This means that we need to change something in our advertisement. Also, if we have chosen the wrong keywords, then our Google search results are displayed to the wrong people. And this means there's a bad conversion rate from the Google search result to our landing page. Our advertisement is simply shown to the wrong people. And the same applies, of course, to the targeting here. If we choose the wrong targets, which means male instead of female, or the wrong age group, or the wrong location, then we will never get any good conversions here from our search result on the Google search page to our landing page. Please be careful. It is not sufficient to just look at the micro conversion rates here in the extended Google AdWords sales funnel. The most important feature is whether we make won or lost deals from the extra leads that we have generated. Now let's look at how we do A-B split testing with two landing pages. We have again the same setup as mentioned before, our company that wants to rent out office space in Singapore, and we have a user who wants to rent office space in Singapore. What we do is we set up a second landing page, and it comes with a second call to action. We program our Google AdWords such that a part of the requests is directed to the company landing page A, and another part of the requests is directed to the company landing page B. And we make it such that it's 50-50. The users for both landing pages would give us their email addresses, and we provide some free content. The email addresses will later be used in order to engage with the potential customer in order to find out what they need and whether we can help them. This is the basic principle of A-B split testing done with two landing pages and Google AdWords searching in the internet. This is quite revolutionary. We have now three sales funnels. First, we have the extended Google AdWords sales funnel of Team A on the left-hand side, and we have the extended Google AdWords sales funnel of the Team B on the right-hand side. Both teams get 50% of our lead generation budget. Using that lead generation budget, Team A generates a number of leads and Team B generates a number of leads. And these leads, of course, must go through our opportunities machine through the different sales stages in order to find out whether there are deals won or lost. I give you an example on how such an A-B split testing could look like, and I show you here two different web pages. And you would be surprised to hear that the right landing page generates more leads than the left one. We don't know why this is the case, but it is so. Maybe it is the different combination of colors. Maybe it is the difference because here we show photos of the rooms and here is a photo of the building. You never know. This is why there is A-B split testing. The differences between successful landing pages and unsuccessful landing pages are often minor. I don't believe that you can predict that. So now I have just shown you an improvement of the landing page here on this level. So if you improve the landing page on this level, more people would click on the call to action button. But this is not all. You can also improve the Google AdWords copy, which means the text that is shown on the search result page of Google. Then you can also optimize the keywords. It is also a question of the price or the budget that you have there. And you can also choose a different targeting. A lot of optimizations can be done, and this is why you use two teams. There is no better or worse team. To me, creating a good landing page is largely random and can seldom be predicted. This is why we use the law of big numbers and A-B split testing. As always, don't forget, whatever leads you get here, these are not automatic sales. You need to work them through the opportunity stages in order to find out whether they would purchase or not. This is a lot of work that comes just after investing into the landing page. How does this look like in practice? And is there further information available? Yes, there is. Check out the courses section on my webpage, www.iplawyertools.com. Please note, there's a membership and all course fees there come with a 1 month, 100% no question asked money back guarantee. My name is Martin Schweiger and I have just walked you through lesson 5 of our marketing and sales bootcamp. Goodbye.